Hey guys, what's happening? This is Graham Daly in association with Red Rock and Cut with me, Amy. And I'm sitting here. I have to say, he's like one of those artists that are just getting so much attention right now. He's Devlin.
What's going on,
man? Welcome to Graham Daly.
Thank you very much.
How you doing?
I'm doing very well, thank you.
I have to say, I'm a bit mad with you though.
Why?
Because like, I was really expecting your album, January, and like, I'm still waiting.
Well, no, it's been a long time, man. I said I was going to bring it out. Probably it must be coming up to 2 years ago now, but I tried making it, and it just didn't sound like an album, man, so we put that as the art of rolling as a mixtape. And yeah, man, it just didn't have the album for it, it had more of a mixtape vibe to it, so we went in, then after that we done the videos, I got signed, so my situation completely changed, man, and obviously now it's a lot more professional, so we got to do the campaign justice. So yeah, I'm gutted, I want it out as well, but these things
take time. So have you gone back and done more work to it, and are you happy with it now, or are you still working on it?
No, I'm happy with it. I had some of the album recorded anyway, but obviously when I signed to Ireland, they had me in with a lot of producers and that, and the studio a lot, so we've done a lot more work, and we just strengthened what we had already. But now, yeah, I'm happy, but now we've got to do the campaign with the singles and that. We've got Brainwash coming out on the 8th of August next week, so yeah, man.
Loving the video.
You like it, yeah?
Yeah, definitely. Thanks. It's DV, L-I-N, your girlfriend thinks I'm handsome. I'll brainwash your mind like Darren Brown or Charlie Manson. You won't suggest I'm random when I take the scene for ransom. And I'm packing out stadiums where the fans singing my anthems. Dirty like Leslie Grantham, this is my manipulation. So yeah, just focus on pushing that at the moment, but it's all the process in it, man. But no, I can't wait. January, the album will be there. So, I
want to
take it back to when you first started out. Now, when you were 13 when you were writing lyrics.
Yeah.
What kind of lyrics are you writing at 13 years old?
Terrible lyrics that I've never recited. Not very good lyrics, man, but no, everyone has to start somewhere. But yeah, man, I just started and improved. I was listening to the old school radio shows, like, no, I think Sharky Major was the first MC I ever heard. Like, I knew about the old school garage and that, but I was only young then. And I think I turned on Deja by accident one night and I heard Sharky spitting, and that was it, man, grabbed me in. Started listening, started writing. And then, yeah, man, I met my boy Dogsy, put me on Rinse, and that was it. I was around in people I'd been listening to for years, so.
Is that when you were kind of part of the OT crew?
Yeah, man, that's when I've been repping the man at Dagenham and it for years. I used to listen to Dogs when I was a baby, listening to him on Rinse and the rest of them. But, so it was nice, man. I was with the boys from the man at Dagenham thing, like, yeah, they looked after me.
What's happening with the OT crew now, though?
A lot, man. We've done a lot. We've been in the studio. We've got Beyond the Booth, Louis White and Roars. And my other boys and me and Dogs and my term, not another boy, one of my OT boys. Just doing a lot of work in there. We want to get some videos rolling, so you should look out for them soon. And yeah, man, we want to hit them up. We're going to try and hit them up from every angle now, but we've been getting busy and making some good music, man. So yeah, I'm excited to get that little project rolling as well.
You had Tales of the Crypt, which you got a lot of attention for. Did you expect it to be so big?
I didn't, man. No, like, it was crazy, you know what I mean? I think I was 15 when I started making that.
Probably that's so
about,
young.
Oh, no, I might have been 16. I might have finished that when I was 17, I think. Just hit 17. And that was great. It done a lot for me, man. That helped me. That's when I really, really got my fan base, like a sly little fan base.
Is that when you kind of realised, you know what, I can do this. Like, this is what I want to do. There's nothing else.
I've always loved making music, but until last year, I didn't really see this taking. That's when it got serious, you know what I mean? When I was sitting in Ireland's ballroom, you know what I mean? And that's when it was serious. But I was just doing it for the love of music, you know what I mean? I nicked a pound over for me mixtapes. I didn't have much when I was young, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just nicking a bit of cash, shotting them on road and wherever I could get rid of them.
What kind of advice would you give to aspiring MCs out there?
It's just hard, man. I can't say nothing. If you really want it that bad, go and work and work like a dog for it. And try and be better than everyone else, man. Try and do things that people ain't doing. Think, how can I come and switch it up? What has someone not done before? But it's hard work, really, man. You know what I mean? If you want to do it, just go and crack on, but it ain't going to happen overnight. Well, it might do. You might be lucky, but it took me like 6 years worth of writing, 7 years of writing.
Because you were really into poetry and stuff, weren't you?
No, I weren't. I weren't, man. I've been misquoted there.
Did you get into
poetry? Do you know what? I appreciate it. I said in school, I weren't a big fan of poetry at all, but I appreciated the double meanings, the twisting tales in English and stories. Like, some of them plays will bore you to death, you know what I mean? But I could appreciate some aspects of them, and so that's what I would say. Yeah. No, I did love English and the language.
London City got so much attention too.
Yeah.
Tell us about that. Is that all about having fun?
That is, yeah, just me and the boys, me and Dogs in the hat and a night hat. That's a happy record for me, man. Most of my songs, my mum said to me, why don't you try and make an happy song? Like, you're a bit depressing, boy, ain't you? So that's my version of happy music.
Just out there mingling, having a few drinks with the boys, chilling.
Yeah.
And tonight we're in London City. I'm on the 813 on the way to the city. Where the lights are bright with some boys that like to fight. I'm leaning out a window smoking a spliffy.
I didn't go in too deep on the concept, and with the bars, like rapid fire flow, I just tried to sit back and relax, man. Done a lot for me. That one took me by surprise. But probably my first. I've made songs before, like Community Outcast and that, but that had a nice little vibe to it, do you know what I mean? That's, so,
I progression. I think it was number one on AKA for a long time.
It was, man, it was. Like, yeah, I think that was the start of the progression, man, in the music I was making.
Do you reckon it's because people seen a different kind of side to you, kind of like a fun side?
Yeah, I think I grew up a bit. I matured, and you have to branch out, don't you, man, and show that I'm capable of making all sorts of music, you know what I mean, to acquire for everyone's taste.
Now, you signed to Island Records. Good luck.
Very good luck, yeah.
Obviously the same label as Wiley and Strider. Is that kind of what influenced your decision of going with Island Records?
Do you know what? Not at all, man. We've done a few record labels you're interested in, and I was over the moon. We've done the Rands, and I just felt much more comfortable here, man. Everyone at Island was lovely, do you know what I mean? Made me feel comfortable. Didn't want to switch up what I was doing. They was happy with the music I was making and said they just wanted to keep making my music. So yeah, I felt most comfortable here. But obviously the success of Strider, you can't knock that either. I looked at that, but it wasn't a major part, but I looked at it and thought, like, boy, they know what they're doing. Like the Sugar Babes, Winehouse,
yeah.
Bob Marley, you can't argue with it really, can you? So, but no, I just felt more relaxed here, like, I felt right.
So as an artist, do you have the leeway to be as creative as you want?
I really do, you know.
There's no limits as to what you can
or
can't do.
They're brilliant, man. They just let me go studio, crack on, and 9 times out of 10 they're happy, man. Suggestions, you know what I mean? They always throw in a suggestion, and that's good. But you can't argue with their experience in their field. They've done this with artists millions of times before, but no, they showed faith in me to go and do what I want, so really, I appreciate that. It means a lot to me.
So as Wiley and Strider are on the same label, do you reckon we'll ever have a track with all three of you guys on?
Never say never, but I don't know, I'm just focused, as I said. I ain't even dropped my first single yet, do you know what I mean? But yeah, never say never, you know what I mean?
So what inspires you to write your lyrics?
I couldn't tell you, man. Sometimes my brain just clicks on.
So we could be sitting here and you could just think of something?
Yeah, and some days I could sit there for an hour and not write a word, do you know what I mean? But I don't know, so just experiences in my own life, maybe stuff that goes on around me. Maybe if I hear a nice word or get a little idea, a little spark in my head, that will trigger me off, and then you're gone. When you're on one, do you know what I mean? When you're in that zone, it's fluent, like you start rolling, but sometimes it's hard to get into that little zone. It comes and goes as it pleases sometimes.
So you're on the list of BBC's Sound of 2010, that's Rising Stars. That's a good look still.
Yeah, man.
But you've been doing this for a while, so to get the attention now, how does it feel?
It feels good. I think it's the right time, because as I said, I was very young when I started all this. So maybe I went at the mental age to be ready for all this, you know what I mean? Now I feel like I've done my training, like radio over the years, in the battleground, in the raves, that's all practice. And now I'm confident that I think it was a good time, and everything happens for a reason. I think I'm ready for this now.
How does it feel like, obviously, when you have youngsters come up to you and they're like, oh, you know, we love what you're doing? That must be a buzz in itself.
It is, man, it is. I just like it because the kids, man, if you can encourage the kids to start writing and that, right, because there's not much out there, you know what I mean? If you get into music or something, not even music, something you can love and put your good energy in that, keep your head above them, man, you know what I mean? So it's good. So there is opportunity and everyone's breaking through, so that's a good positive look for the kids, man. When I come up, like, we just had like radio and raves, just like the rest of them, like Wiley,
yeah.
Dogs, Gets, every, I could go on forever, like, that's all it was really, like radio and raves. Like. But now, like, there's a lot of opportunity. Artists are getting signed. So if you want to put the work in, mate, there's a good chance you could do this.
Message for the fans?
Message for the fans. Fans have been brilliant, man. Just thank you, everyone that's getting behind me and what I'm doing. And I'm going to just keep trying to go in for you, mate, giving you good music.
And what else can we expect from Devlin?
Can expect to just see me a lot more. Just to see me, man, getting in, mate. It's been, as you said, I've been around for a little while now. Nah, it's just no rest for the wicked time we're going in, so I can't wait, I'm buzzing. See me going in, watch out for grime freestyles, rap tunes, albums, mix CDs, like we're just gonna just going to do this thing now.
So do we have a date on the album?
January, that's your date.
January
next year. She's pushing, ain't she? She's pushing herself.
I try.
I can't wait for it to be out, but it'll be out in January anyway, definitely.
Okay, thank you for taking time out to speak to us on Grime Daily. Devlin.
Cheers, man. Take care.
Everybody stand up, I got this feeling. When I stand up, I'll have to bend my neck so my cranium don't touch the ceiling. I'm defiant, call me Andre the Giant. Hell of a monster of a man.